Hello, and welcome to the video tutorial on how to use Busways in EcoStruxure Power Design Ecodial. In this demonstration, you will view the procedures to size uniform horizontal busways, size non-uniform horizontal busways, size uniform vertical busways, and size non-uniform vertical busways. Let's begin by sizing a uniform busway for horizontal distribution. A horizontal distribution busway has to be added to this installation. First, select a proper feeder circuit which could be connected to horizontal busway. Then, select the horizontal distribution BTS and connect it to the feeder. The busway can be calculated for uniform or non-uniform tap-off units distribution. We will keep the distribution as uniform. Set the length of the busway. Connect the loads to the busway. Edit the required details for the connected loads. Next, calculate the network. Next, we will view how to size a non-uniform busway for horizontal distribution. A horizontal distribution busway has to be added to this installation. After the feeder circuit is connected, add the horizontal distribution BTS. The busway can be calculated for uniform or non-uniform tap-off units distribution. We will keep the distribution as non-uniform. Set the length of the non-uniform busway. Next, connect the loads to the busway. When the busway is set to non-uniform distribution, the distance from origin has to be set for each tap-off unit. Calculate the network. After calculation for non-uniform busway, the short circuit currents and voltage drops are calculated for each feeder. If the distance from origin of a feeder is more than the length of the BTS, then the network calculation will show an error. You can view the details in the alarm window. Next, we will view how to size a uniform busway for vertical distribution. A vertical distribution busway has to be added to this installation. Ensure that you select a proper feeder circuit which can be connected to vertical busway. After the feeder circuit is connected, add the vertical BTS riser. The vertical busway can be calculated for uniform or non-uniform tap-off units distribution. We will keep the distribution as uniform. Next, set the length of the busway. Connect the required loads to the busway. Provide all the necessary inputs to the busway and connected loads. Calculate the network. Next, we will view how to size a non-uniform busway for vertical distribution. A vertical distribution busway has to be added to this installation. Ensure that you select a proper feeder circuit, which can be connected to vertical busway. After the feeder circuit is connected, add the vertical BTS riser. The busway can be calculated for uniform or non-uniform tap-off units distribution. We will keep the distribution as non-uniform. Set the length of the non-uniform busway. Next, connect the loads to the busway. When the busway is set to non-uniform distribution, the distance from origin has to be set for each tap-off unit. Calculate the network. After calculation for non-uniform busway, the short circuit currents and voltage drops are calculated for each feeder. If the distance from origin of a feeder is more than the length of the BTS, then the network calculation will show an error. You can view the details in the alarm window. This concludes the video on how to use busways. In this video, we saw how to size uniform horizontal busways, size non-uniform horizontal busways, size uniform vertical busways, and size non-uniform vertical busways.